Hi, my name is Flo, and in this video I want to inform you why I think Tesla is on a winning streak. But first I want to ask you to subscribe to my channel and also hit the notification bell. It is much appreciated and it helps the channel a lot. Some days ago I have read an interview with the Mercedes CEO Ola Källenius, who said that Mercedes is planning to introduce an operating system called MBOS. With comparable features like Tesla's software. For example, extensive over-the-air updates are planned. Sounds great, don't you think? So, when will it be released? In 2025, said Ola Källenius. 2025. That's 5 years from now and 13 years after Tesla's first over-the-air update. Can you imagine how advanced Tesla's software will be in 2025? When Mercedes releases its first try? With this innovative spirit, I don't see a bright future for Mercedes. The interview got me thinking what other things, apart from the well-known over-the-air updates, Tesla today does better than the competition. In no particular order, here are my thoughts, and they are many. So to make this video not too long, I tried not to go into too much detail with every point. I just want to make some form of eye-opener video of what Tesla offers already today, especially for its customers. Let's start. The Tesla Supercharger Network. A Tesla owner is independent of third-party charging network providers, who, for example, have their own app or need their own customer card, which can get quite annoying when traveling long distances and using different chargers in different regions. Also, for example, the Tesla navigation system routes you with an optimal use of the supercharger's charging power to reach your destination in a timely manner, as well as, for example, the possibility to check ahead in your car if the chargers are in use or not in use. This is a level of convenience and offers peace of mind that other car manufacturers cannot offer to this extent. Next, safety. Teslas are known to achieve very impressive crash test results worldwide. The main reason for this is the way an electric car is packaged, which allows optimizing the crash structures of the car to the best level possible. Tesla uses this opportunity to the fullest and invests much time in optimizing their cars for excellent crash results. But that is not all. Tesla also uses the sensor array of their cars not only for driving in the autopilot mode, but also to do everything possible to avoid a crash before it could happen. In the end, Tesla customers know they are driving one of the safest cars on the planet. My next point is Tesla's battery technology. Since years, Teslas have the longest range of any electric car in their respective price range. And there are many arguments what could be the reason why Tesla offers so much range in their cars. For example, it could be the most advanced battery structure, or it could be the smallest battery buffer size, or it could be the most intelligent battery management. No matter what it is, in the end, the customer knows buying a Tesla also buys him the best range. Another plus of Tesla is reliability. Teslas are not known to need replacements and repairs frequently. Teslas can achieve very high mileages before battery or drive unit needs replacement. Even the seemingly smaller battery buffer size compared to the German offerings does not seem to hurt Tesla's reliability. So a Tesla buyer does not need to worry that this new technology that is used in his car is going to lead to expensive repairs. Over the years, Tesla proved to offer reliable cars. Fast acceleration is another strong point of Tesla. Tesla was the first company actively pursuing the idea that electric cars should be fun, not boring and slow. Tesla managed to combine the idea of driving emission-free and have fun doing so. Of course, this was only possible because Teslas are rather expensive cars compared to a Toyota Prius or a Nissan Leaf. And today, you can also get a Nissan Leaf with around 200 horsepower. But through the years, Tesla is now associated with fast acceleration, and the reason for this was pursuing the acceleration idea from the beginning. Today, Tesla still actively tries to improve acceleration times for every model, whether through new electronics or new software. A Tesla customer knows he drives one of the fastest cars in its respective class, and the customer surely does not want to have less acceleration with his next car. So customers will stay, because they don't want to miss out the fast acceleration. The next advantage of Tesla, the autopilot. Tesla's autopilot became more or less the synonym of automated driving, even if other car and tech companies offer or develop technology for automated driving. Tesla has the longest experience with this technology in customer hands and is therefore the one company where automated driving is most associated with. An experience gained with automated driving in customer hands is probably one of Tesla's biggest treasures. It leads to knowledge other car manufacturers don't have. But why does Tesla know more about automated driving than other car manufacturers? This leads to my next point, machine learning. As you probably know, Teslas are connected to Tesla servers, for example to receive over-the-air updates or traffic information. But Tesla also uses this connectivity for machine learning purposes. Machine learning is, simplified, a way to make software better through try and error or experience. So Tesla uses its thousands of cars to monitor the road and traffic situation. If a Tesla encounters a dangerous or complicated situation the autopilot could not handle and the driver needed to take control of the car, the situation is sent to Tesla to learn from it and then use it in the machine learning algorithm. So the idea is that the Tesla autopilot software learns how to react to this kind of situation and will handle it by itself in the future. Also, there are rumors that Tesla monitors especially good drivers regularly to teach their cars to drive like this good driving customers. The most important thing to know from the two points autopilot and machine learning is that data for machine learning is the gold of the 21st century. And Tesla has collected huge amounts of data for their machine learning algorithm in the last years. And in my personal opinion, this data is probably the most valuable knowledge Tesla possesses. It is more valuable than battery tech or electric motors. It is a knowledge a company can only gain through millions of miles in the real world. I am convinced no fleet of experimental self-driving cars or group of test drivers can offer this variety of worldwide traffic situations to let your software learn from. As I already mentioned before, another advantage of Tesla are the software updates. And Tesla uses these updates in every way possible, which means improvements to existing features and adding completely new features. Just as an example, a feature that was added as an update some years ago. The bigger Teslas come with air suspension, and you can raise the air suspension when needed, for example, when you have a steep driveway. With an update, the cars remembered where the suspension has been raised regularly and will now do it on their own. Tesla calls this feature auto-raising suspension. Another example from the last months are enabling a little bit more range, a little bit better acceleration, or the much talked about smart summon feature. Keeping your car always up to date, like your smartphone or computer, is a feature that offers customers some form of peace of mind, knowing even years down the road that Tesla is still equipped with modern features. Another strong point of Tesla is their own hardware. Today Tesla is using hardware called Hardware 3 for controlling its advanced self-driving and driver assist features. And Tesla does not buy this hardware off the shelf from, for example, Nvidia or Intel. Like Apple, Tesla develops their own chips perfectly tailored to the Tesla ecosystem. And on top of that, their chips and hardware are also extremely capable. It is not that Hardware 3 is years behind the automotive offerings of experienced competitors like Nvidia. So again, an advantage for Tesla by using hardware and software made in-house, thus having the opportunity to optimize hardware and software to work perfectly together. The customer profits from this decision. Another point that leads to happy customers is that Tesla cares. For example, there have been reports that Tesla unlocked additional battery capacity for customers who needed to leave hazard zones, for example hurricanes or wildfires, or that Tesla informed their customers through their app to charge their cars to 100% because a utility company announced power outages. It is a nice feeling knowing that Tesla would help you in difficult situations. This brings me to my next strong point of Tesla, their fans. There is probably no car company in the world who has so much loyal fans. They buy Teslas since years, they recommend Teslas to friends and family, they start YouTube channels dedicated to Tesla, they are active in forums and online communities, they help each other with tips and tricks. It is probably one of the biggest communities surrounding a product or company, and this also helps potential customers in their decision to buy a Tesla. And this leads me to Elon Musk, also one of Tesla's strong points. Without Elon Musk, Tesla would probably not stand where they stand today. Elon Musk is someone who pushes what's technologically possible, and on top of that is open-minded to new ideas. He also listens to his customers and fans. Sometimes ideas for improvements of the car's software are coming to Elon Musk through Twitter, and he then orders his engineers to realize this idea. This is completely new to the car industry. Also, his courage to see potential in radical decisions like building gigafactories for cars and batteries, or using completely new ways to construct a car like we see with the Cybertruck, are big advantages for Tesla. Elon Musk is okay with taking risks, and this is a big plus for Tesla and its customers. Risks lead me to my next point, Tesla's openness to radical ideas. In many ways, Tesla is doing things differently than other car manufacturers. They use huge gigafactories for batteries and cars. With the Cybertruck, they plan to fold metal parts instead of stamping it. They will not paint the Cybertruck, it is stainless steel. They make their own chip designs as we see with Hardware 3. They build factories as fast as possible, as we have seen with the Gigafactory 3 in China and we see with the Gigafactory 4 in Germany. Tesla moves fast and fearless, something other car companies do not even dare to do. And in the end, the customer profits. The cars get cheaper, the range is longer, and the production is faster. Fearless leads to my next point. Do you know that Tesla offers other car manufacturers to use their patents? Tesla is especially open to the idea that other car manufacturers use the supercharger technology. This way both will benefit from a bigger charging network. The idea was revealed in 2014, but sadly to this day no other car manufacturer uses supercharger technology. But it again shows the customer that Tesla is doing everything in its power to broaden the usage of electric cars. Now comes my last strong point of Tesla, the market capitalization. We all know the news of the kurs rally of Tesla in the last weeks and that a share is now worth around $1,000. No matter this number is now overhyped or not, it is a big statement. Tesla is, as of making this video, worth more than Volkswagen, Daimler and BMW together. The market capitalization is not directly the price someone would need to pay if you wanted to buy the company, but it lets you calculate roughly what you would need to pay for 100% or 51% of the company. And this also helps the customer to have peace of mind. Tesla is half car company, half tech company, and the market value now reflects that. If anyone wants to buy a majority stake in Tesla today, he would have a very expensive adventure, and therefore I don't think this will happen. Tesla is now in price regions when they do not need to fear that some other car company buys them and buries them. So that's it from me, and let me know what you think about Tesla in the comments below. And please like, share, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell, as more videos are coming soon.